Assalamualaikum brothers and sisters. So in this second part of chapter 4, we are going to cover the DC analysis of BJT circuits and the load lines. Okay? So the DC analysis of BJT is very easy. All you need to do is to do KVL at the BE loop and CE loop. So I will show you later on where are these loops for you to do the KVL. Okay? So before I proceed to the analysis, I think it is important that I show you the circuit symbol for your NPN. So this is the circuit symbol for your NPN BJT. So the middle one, which is the P type, is the base terminal. And then the two N types, you can see here, you have the emitter terminal and the collector terminal. So the current directions, it is very important for you to label these current directions correctly. But it is very easy for you to identify the direction of IE because of the arrow here in the circuit symbol. So IE will just follow the direction of this arrow. Next, as for direction of IB and IC, because IE is the main current, and remember the KCL equation, IE is equivalent to IB plus IC. So that's why IB and IC will be directed in this direction, so that IB plus IC equivalent to IE. Okay? Next, so normally for BJT DC analysis, you are asked to calculate what are these currents. And normally you are given this value, VBE, which is your V gamma for the diode. And also normally you are given the value of beta or alpha. So whenever you are given this information, there is no problem for you to find these three currents. So in addition to finding all these currents, you are also normally required to calculate what is the voltage between terminal C and E, referred to as VCE. So for example, this is a circuit constructed. So your NPN transistor is here. Okay. There are two power supplies. One is to bias this junction BE, and then another one is to bias the junction BC. So for junction BC, you would like to make it reverse bias. Okay. You can see here, unless given, always assume VBE equivalent to 0.7. In other words, your V gamma is always 0.7 volt. So let's start with the first loop, the BE loop. Okay. When you are referring to BE loop, you are actually looking at the loop associated with terminal B and E. Remember why I said it is important for you to know current direction? It's because you need to know what is the voltage across your RB. So the polarity across your RB will be this way. Okay. So that's why you need to know the direction of those currents. Okay. So for this BE loop, the KVL equation can be derived as follows. So VBE minus VBB plus IBRB equivalent to 0. So you can rearrange the equation to calculate IB. So once you do that, you can use IC equivalent to beta IB in order to calculate IC, and then use KCL to calculate IE. So normally, once you find one current, you are able to calculate the other currents by using the current gain beta or alpha. So from the BE loop, we can derive the input load line, IB versus VBE. If you still can recall the diode DC load line, you derive the KVL and make it Y equals to MX plus C. So it is the same concept. The input load line, IB versus VBE, is derived from the BE loop. So this is the BE loop that I have shown you just now, and this is the KVL equation. So you have to rearrange the equation to make IB as Y, VBE as X. So this term here as the Y intercept and the slope, which is this part. Okay, so you can see the slope is negative value, which in this case is minus 1 over RB. Okay, the input load line is actually the same as the load line for the diode. Because your BE junction here, which is the PN junction diode, it is fault bias. So that's why it is actually the same as the diode DC load line. So you can see here, this is the spider look alike circuit that we have encountered in multiple diode, kan? So you need to connect this power supply to the common ground. Okay, so I'm going to transform this. Ta-da! So now you can see the loop and you can do the KVL. Okay, so this is the equation, VBE minus 4 plus IBRB. And so rearrange the equation to make IB as Y and VBE as X. So this will be your Y intercept, and the slope is minus 1 over 220K. Now, this term is equivalent to 18.2 microampere, and the x-intercept can be found by making IB as 0. So, to complete this input load line, you need to draw this line, right? This is just like your VD here, okay? Alright? And this is your ID. So, just like your diode, this is your VD and ID. But in the case of BJT, this will be your VBE on, and this will be your IB. So, it is very easy for you to derive the input load line, which is from the BE loop. You just need to get the KVL equation and derive the Y equivalent to MX plus C. So, next is the CE loop. So, obviously, the CE loop is derived from this loop that involves the terminals C and E, right? So, when you do a DC analysis of BJT, you should start from the BE loop in order to get the currents. So, when you do your CE loop, you have already obtained the value for your collector current IC. Okay, so what is the KVL equation? So, when you do your KVL, it will be this equation. So, you can see VCE minus VCC plus IC RC. So, based on the current direction of IC, so you can see here that I have placed the polarity for the voltage across RC as follows. Okay, so if BE loop is used to derive the input load line, the CE loop is used to derive what we refer to as the output load line, which is IC versus VCE. So similar to the input load line, the output load line is also derived from the KVL equation of the CE loop here. Okay, so when you got this KVL equation, you rearrange to make IC as the Y axis. VCE will be representing the X, and this term here is your Y intercept, and again you will have a negative slope here. Okay, so if you look at the same example just now where we have done the BE loop, I did the KVL here at my CE loop, I will obtain this equation for the Y equivalent to MX plus C. So at first, I plot the DC load line here, right? So the y-intercept is 10 over 2. So that's how I get the 5 here. And then the x-intercept is obtained by setting IC as 0. And I will get the x-intercept as 10 volt. However, in order to complete the output load line, you need to draw this curve here. Okay, so you can see that I highlighted the curve with this yellow highlighter. So you need to draw this curve, and the intercept of that curve with this load line is called the Q point, right? So this curve is actually the base current value that we have calculated from the BE loop. So this Q point is referred to as the values of IC and VCE at IB equivalent to 15 microampere. So in order to calculate the value of IC, you will use this equation, IC equivalent to beta IB. And once you get this value, you can place this value inside this equation for you to get the value of VCE. Okay, so that's how it works. Firstly, get the KVL equation, change it to Y equivalent to MX plus C, find the intercepts, then don't forget to draw the negative slope, don't forget this IB curve, and the point of intersection is where you need to calculate IC, and place the value inside here to get your VCE. So you need to do this approach when you are asked to sketch the output load line. Okay? Okay, so now let's do some examples for your BJT DC analysis. So the first circuit is as follows. So in this circuit is a bit different because you can see here, now the circuit has RE, but there is no RB. So as you rearrange the power supply to be as follows, now you can see the loop. Therefore, you can do your KVL easier. However, one thing you need to take note is that don't forget to assign the current direction, okay, as follows. So remember, your IE must be following the arrow in the circuit symbol here. Then based on KCL, IB and IC are in this direction. Okay, so now let's do the KVL at this loop, okay, which is the BE loop. So the equation will be VBE plus IERE minus 4. Because the question did not give you the value for VBE, you can assume that VBE equivalent to 0.7. Okay, so this is the KVL at BE loop, and straight away you can obtain the value of the emitter current, which is 1 milliampere. Okay, I have informed before that once you get one current, and if you are given the current gain, you can calculate the other currents. So in this case, you are given alpha. Therefore, you can calculate IC because IC equivalent to alpha IE. So you get IC equivalent to 0.99 milliampere. Then using KCL equation, you can calculate IB. So IB equivalent to IE minus IC. So 0.01 milliampere is the base current. Okay, done. Now you want to do the CE loop in order to find the voltage VCE over here. So you perform KVL at your CE loop here. Alright, and you will get the equation ICRC plus VCE plus IERE minus 10. So because you have calculated all the currents, you can get the answer straight away. VCE equivalent to 2.047 volt. So this next example is not in your slide. I just thought I'd give you more examples for you to try out. So I would like to suggest that you pause this video and you try this on your own before I reveal the answer. Okay? Haha, you didn't pause the video, did you? So anyway, what you need to do is to change this power supply so that it is connected to the common ground. And then don't forget to identify the current directions. So I'm going to show this on the whiteboard.
A few moments later.
Okay, so this is the example in your slide. So you can see here the power supply, the resistors RB, RC and RE. The voltages are VBE and VCE. You are given beta equivalent to 99. Okay. So first thing is you're going to change this into the common ground, okay? And at the same time, I'm going to label the current directions, okay? So your RE is connected to ground, okay? So just draw your power supply like this, okay? And this power supply is 5.7 volt. So your RB and then your RC, and bring this power supply like this, okay, and connect it to ground. So this is 10.7 volt, alright, and this is your RC, okay. So current direction, this is your IE, your IB going into the transistor, and this is your IC, so that IB plus IC equivalent to IE, okay. And the question did not give what is VBE, so we're going to assume that VBE equivalent to 0.7 volt, okay, because it's not given, eh? And this is your VCE voltage. So we're going to find these three currents and find the voltage VCE, okay. Gonna wipe this off, eh? So the BE loop is here, okay. So I'm going to do starting from your VBE, right? So this is my VBE. So normally students forget about VBE because it's not labeled in the circuit or in the question, so you tend to miss it. So I hope that you can always remember that there is this VBE term. Eh? So VBE plus IERE minus 5.7 plus IBRB equivalent to 0. Okay. However, in this example, because you have these two resistors, so you have these two terms. Okay. Now, this is where you need to utilize the formulas that I have introduced you in part 1. You want to link the currents. We know that IE equivalent to 1 plus beta IB, which means that it's equivalent to 100 IB. Okay, so you're going to put this term inside here. And finally, you're going to have an equation with only one unknown current. Okay, so I'm going to shift this a bit over here so that I can write more comfortably. So 0.7 plus 100 IB. Don't forget to multiply with RE. So RE in the question is 2. Minus 5.7 plus IB, and RB is 10 kilo ohm equivalent to 0. So from this equation, I can get IB equivalent to 5.7 minus 0.7 is 5. Group this together, I get 210K. So this equivalent to 23.8 microampere. So you have obtained your base current. Okay, so I'm going to wipe this top off. So now you know IB, you can calculate IC using beta IB, alright? And then you can calculate IE equivalent to IB plus IC. So if I solve this first, I will get 2.356 milliampere. And then using the KCL to calculate IE, I will get 2.38
Mili and Pil. Okay, so those are the three currents of BJT, and the only tricky bit here is this. Okay, you need to make sure that you know how to change one current into another current so that the equation only have one unknown. Okay, so now you want to find VCE, so you're going to use the CE loop. And because you have calculated the currents IC and IE, you just need to make sure that your KVL equation is correct. So I have wiped off the calculation just now. Alright, so let's do the KVL for CE loop. So VCE, okay, plus IERE minus 10.7 plus ICRC equivalent to 0. Okay, so you can see here you have an extra term, which is IERE. And of course, you need to make sure the polarity of the voltage across the resistor is correct. You can see here for IB, for example, if the current flows in this direction, the polarity should be plus minus. Alright, so this is my KVL for the CE loop. So we have calculated what is IE and IC, and you know the resistor RE and RC. So you can calculate VCE straight away. So VCE is equivalent to 10.7 minus IC multiplied by 1 kilo ohm minus IE multiplied by 2 kilo ohm, and you will get 3.58 volt. So that's the calculation for VCE and the three currents. So basically, that is the way to solve the BJT DC analysis, KVL at B loop and CE loop. So let's go and have a look at the next example.
So this final example here is similar to the previous one, where you see that each terminal has the resistors. So the question asks for the output load line, which means that you want to plot IC versus VCE. Okay, so the next slide here already guide you that you need to do KVL, okay, at the BE loop. So this is the equation. So to make it easier for you to view the loop, okay, so I have reconstructed the circuit as follows. So now you can see the BE loop here, and the equation is VBE plus IERE minus 6 plus IBRB. Then the equation is rearranged to calculate what is IB. The reason why this step is the first thing you need to do is for you to calculate IB, for you to do the curve for the output load line later, right? The second one is, of course, you want to derive the Y equivalent to MX plus C. So this time the derivation will be from the CE loop over here. Now the main mistake that students do is they calculate what is IE and put in here so that you can get a value. That is incorrect, because what you need to do is you need to change IE into IC. Then you factorize IC and you get this term inside here. So after you compute all these values, you will get this equation. You need to bear in mind that you want to derive an equation Y equivalent to MX plus C, where the variables are Y and X. So in this case, the variables is IC and VCE. So that's why you need to do this step. Okay, so based on the equation just now, you can rearrange to get Y equivalent to MX plus C. So this is the correct equation. So as I mentioned before, find the X and Y intercept. So the Y intercept is 12 over 1.01 is 11.9 milliampere. The X intercept is 12. Don't forget this line here. And again, don't forget this curve. So this curve is the IB curve, and the value is what you have calculated in the BE loop just now, right? So the intercept is the Q point. So compute your IC using beta IB, and then bring this into the equation here. So then the value of VCE is 6.31 volt. So this is just some of the challenging question that can come out using output load line. Okay, so in the next video, I will be covering the bipolar transistor biasing circuit. So I'll see you then. Bye. Assalamualaikum.